Hey guys, it's Dawn. I'm sorry, I just kind of stumbled over my own words. I do get a little camera shy sometimes, but it's been a really long time since I've done a video, and I have something new to share, and I want y'all to guess what I just got. All of these are the Fergie Centerstage collection lipsticks. I went in wild, and I just so happened to be out with a friend one night, and of course, I always go in Walgreens. It's like, I don't know, my pit stop before I come home when I'm out. That's kind of weird, but it was really late at night, and I saw the little stand, and it had a bunch of Wet n Wild products, and I was like, I kind of like Wet n Wild now. You know, they're cheap, and they're really good, so, you know, I decided to buy all of them. Well, except for one. And the one that I didn't get is called Pagan Angel. And it's just a regular black lipstick. And I don't do black, so I didn't really need it. So let's get started. I haven't tried but two of these. So we're going to do this together and see how it works. Now, this one is called VI Pink. You can see that. Yeah, VI Pink. And before I get to talking about this one, look at the packaging. It's really cute this time. It has Fergie's name on it here, and it's a silver, kind of looks like a, excuse me for saying this, but it kind of looks like a bullet. I don't know, it's kind of freaky, but forgive me for saying that, but I mean, that's what it looks like, ladies. I mean, a bullet. So it's called VI Pink, and I just got back from church, so this is the color I wore tonight, you know, just to try it out. And I'm going to show you what it looks like on my hand first. It's a blue-based pink, and it kind of reminds me of Nicki Minaj's Pink Friday. So it's kind of vibrant on. It looks like a mauve-ish color in the tube, though, so I tried it. It's what I had on, so I'm just going to put it back on top of what I had on. And excuse me for looking in the mirror, but and that's what it looks like. It's like a Barbie pink. But if that's too pale, then use a lip liner. I'm using Max. Oh. Sorry. I'm using Max Pro Longwear Lip Pencil in Bittersweet. So that's what I had on earlier. I'm going to put it on again because I want to show you guys the true color. So that was that one. And I'm just going to use a wet towel to wipe my lips off and some Vaseline to keep them moisturized. Wonder who's winning that game downstairs. I can hear it. Okay. So, the next one, I wore this one Sunday because I thought it was really cute, and I read a bunch of blogs, and I heard a lot of people say that this was their favorite one, so I tried it on me, and I liked it, but it's not my favorite red. It's called Old School Glam. And this one is it's a bright red. It's not blue based like Ruby Woo. It's more like MAC red. So it's kind of got a coral undertone, kind of a warm undertone. That's what it looks like. My light may be kind of bright in here. But that's it. This is what it looks like on the lips. And I normally always use a lip liner with reds, but I'm just not gonna do that today. Now this one, the formula for these are a little bit different from the Mega Last ones, the ones that come in the little black packaging. These are a bit creamier. The texture is creamier. And they have a semi-matte finish, so it's not quite matte like the others, but has a little bit of sheen. It's almost like the satin finish, the cream, what's it called? Cream sheen lipsticks from MAC. So that's what it looks like. It's really pretty on camera. Kind of like it. So that one's called Old School Glam. Oh, and these were about $3.49 a piece. And there are 10 of them in the collection. And on the display, they had a coupon for $1 off, but it only works with one item. So when I bought these, I only got $1 off my total purchase, which isn't much, but I mean, you can always use the discount. And they do stain. You see how that red stained my lips? So if you want your lipstick to last all day and sometimes you may not have time to reapply, you could just put some lip balm over it and you'll still have a really pretty flush to your lips. Okay, this next one is called Fergie Daily. Oops. And it's a nude color. Nudes are really tricky for me. Takes me a while to get them right. But the perfect lip liner, nudes can be, they can be okay. So this one is really pale. It's like a pink based nude. That's it. And this is what it looks like on. And once again, I would use my bittersweet lip liner. But it's actually okay on its own because I kind of have a natural dark lip line. But I would more than likely use the lip liner with this. This is not my favorite nude from the bunch, but it's workable. And you could also use this if you wanted to lighten a color. Because I know some lipsticks can be kind of dark and you might want to lighten it. So you could use that to lighten a color. So they can be used for multiple things. And forgive me for talking as I'm wiping. I'm trying to save you guys time because I know you don't like to watch stupid long videos. Hey, do y'all want some music in the background? Let's see what I got on my phone. It's kind of quiet in here. Let's see what I had last playing on Pandora. Probably something crazy. All right, this one I have not opened yet. It is called Penthouse Suite. And this one is a really, this is a really bright pink. It's blue-based. It's a blue-based pink. It kind of reminds me of, it's a CoverGirl color, Spellbound, which is a dupe for MAC's Girl About Town, but I don't think this one is going to be a dupe. It just kind of reminds me of it. So if you're into those bright pinks like that one, then you're going to like this one. See? It's almost like, it's kind of a, where is it? Right there. Almost like a fuchsia color. Oh, I kind of like this one. Speaking of Nicki Minaj. David Guetta. Anyway. Such an appropriate song. Where them girls at? Girls at? My stank face. Oh, but anyway, this is Penthouse Suite again. It's a bright, it's not neon, but it's a bright pink. And it's blue-based. So if you like, Girl About Town or Nouveau Pink, then this one would be a really good one for you. And that's it right there. sorry about my fugly eyebrows today, but I didn't get a chance to groom much. So, you're stuck with looking at my ugly eyebrows. Oh, and this is a good trick that I use when I take out my lipstick. I always use Vaseline in a wet towel. That way, you get some exfoliation and moisturization at the same time. So it's pretty cool. And then your lips are always soft and ready for the next application. Alright, this is another one that I think is gorgeous. It's called Fusionista. Make sure you learn how to spell fuchsia because it's one of the most commonly misspelled words. Yeah. Alright, so this one is a, you call these duochromes. And by that, it means, you can see that it kind of has a blue sheen to it. So, yeah, it's called duochrome. You remember back in the day, like, how those people in Texas used to have the flip-flop color cards? Yeah, I'm from the South, so. I'm not from Texas, though, but I'm from the South, so. I remember seeing those flip-flop colored cards. That's kind of what this looks like. But it's not going to show up blue on your face, so. It reminds me of that. And this one's a little bit darker than Pentel Sweet. There's a NYX lip gloss. That's similar to this. It's a duochrome too. It's called African Queen. And it'll be really pretty on top of it. If you have it. So this is how this looks. It almost looks red. Now this would be gorgeous if you do a sculpted lip. You know how you fill in the edges like with concealer around here and in your cupid's bow? This would be gorgeous for that type of look. So I hope you guys like that. And because it is a duochrome with blue tones in it, it makes your teeth look whiter. See? Look how pretty. My teeth are white, by the way, but they look way whiter with this on. Oh, I should have tried this one last. Look at that. Okay, the next one is called Ferguson Crest Cabernet. And this is a pretty color for fall. You know, everyone's into the berries and the Bordeaux, deep reds and deep plums, purple type colors. This one makes me think of a really nice glass of wine. I'm a wine drinker and I love red wine. So this is what this reminds me of. And that's it. It looks a little red on camera, but it's very much a berry color. And you know what? If you can't really differentiate between the colors on here, I'll put a link to my blog so that you can see all the colors. Oh, I love this one. I always thought I looked the cutest in the berry colors. See? Hope I don't have any boogers. See boogers? No boogers. Ah. Perfect. So that's how that one looks. Yeah, see? This is like how it's different from the other one. I know that's gross, but this is the one I was wearing is way darker than the other one. I got like a clown laughing. But it's okay. All for the sake of beauty, right? And I had this makeup on for a few hours now, but if you guys are wondering, it's just I'm just wearing concealer and with powder over it, and I contoured a little bit on the sides. Can't really tell because I kind of naturally have high cheekbones anyway, but when you contour, you just go through here with a darker powder. You'll see it just a tad. And I highlighted in here, and I just put eyeliner on. So that's all I'm wearing today. And this one is called Divinely Chilled. Now this one is really pretty. This is probably my, I would say this one's my first favorite. The Ferguson Crest Cabernet is my second favorite. But it's kind of like a pearl wine color. It's got a little shimmer in it, which I think is adorable because, I mean, I love creams and everything is a cream now, so it's a nice switch from what everybody else is doing. And besides, of course, trends come and go, so it's okay to have a shimmering one sticking around. Now this one, I would need a lip liner. The texture of this one is not as creamy as all the others, but I still like it because I don't want anything that's shimmery to be too creamy because then it ends up all over your face and I'm not having that. So this is what this one looks like. And you can see how the light reflects off of it right here. So it's a really cute color. I blow kisses. I don't do duck faces. No, it's... I'm kidding. Everybody does a duck face, including me. I forgot to swatch that one on my hand. That's it. Right here. And you can see the shimmer in it, actually. Alright, I have two more left. And once again, there's one more in the collection that I do not have, and it is called Pagan Angel. And it's just a flat color, and I just didn't feel the need to buy that one. Now, if I'm doing someone's makeup and they request a black lipstick, then of course I'll go find one, but just for my own preference, I'm not. And then for a black, I would prefer the OCC Lip Tar anyway because of the way they apply and their elastic power. And you cannot have smeared black lipstick that is so tacky. It's got to be perfect. And black is actually gorgeous when you have a sculpted lip, so I don't knock it. It's just not for me. This one's called Saragina. And this one's a really... true red. It reminds me of the pinup looks. It's kind of Marilyn Monroe-ish if you ask me, so who doesn't love her? Sometimes it's hard to get that cupid's bow. This is it. And this color, I hope she sees this, but this color makes me think of my friend Kiki because she always wears red lipstick. And I think it's so cute on her. And it's just like her signature thing. She's not Kiki if she's not wearing her red lipstick. That's it on my hand. That's it on my lips. And it's really sexy. So girls, go out and get these. They're only $3.50. You can't beat that. And there's another girl on YouTube, and I love her so much. She's originally from Alabama, and she's so country and so cute, and I know I'm country too, and that's why I love her. Her name is Anitra. Her YouTube name is Nitra B, and she always says, can't beat that with a stick, girlfriend. I love it. Yeah, this red can get everywhere. It's like, oh my chin. All right, last one. This one is called Bebot Love. Well, I pronounce it Bebot. I don't know what everybody else says, but Bebot is actually a Filipino word that means babe. So I think it's kind of cute. And it's a nude. It's more of the brown based. It's different from Fergie Daily in that the Fergie Daily is pink undertone and this one is brown. So this is the one that I really like. This is my favorite nude from the collection. And there's a lip gloss by Revlon. That's a little similar to this that I like to put on top of this. I can't think of the name of it right now. But I'll put it down there. And that's it. Makes me like a little girl, but let me show you the trick. So if you want to darken it up a little bit, you see how it's kind of contoured? Looks really good that way. And this is bittersweet again. So I hope y'all enjoyed my Walgreens haul. And I want you guys to go get these because they're cheap and they're still cute. They're in really cute packaging and you don't have to spend a lot of money to look good because for one, you're already beautiful. So there's no need to go spend $75 on a lipstick. No. Just, you know, rock what you got. Be a baller on a budget. There's nothing wrong with that. And, yeah. I'll see you guys later.